Good morning. Kind of a cool morning out here on our patio. And really, this summer in general, it's not been as hot as it normally is in Northern California. But we will be warming up just a little bit. And certified athletic trainer Matt Easley, the athletic trainer at John F. Kennedy High School in Sacramento, is joining us because a lot of parents, Matt, I think, are a little worried as kids go back to school and start a lot of the practices, making sure the kids are handling the heat or whatever the elements are.
Yeah, definitely. It can be a big problem with the heat stroke and heat exhaustion.
Yeah, so a couple things we should be looking out for. So our parents have been asking some questions here on Facebook. Let me throw a couple of them at you.
Okay.
Jackie Griffin says, I have a skinny football player. I want to make sure he's adding some good food to his diet. I want him to gain some LBs. So what's an ideal meal for me to feed him before practice in the evening? And maybe some ideas for meals in general for him.
You know, there is no ideal meal, but anything, definitely the nutrition is the best aspect of the meal. You just want to have it balanced. You want to have your fats and proteins and carbohydrates, but nothing too heavy. But if they want to gain weight, the simplest way is take in more calories than you burn. So just add a little bit extra in there and make sure it's good food, though.
Make sure it's good food. It's mathematical formula. Sylvia Thomas wants to know, is it best for my boys just to drink temperature room water when they're out in the heat every day at football practice? I heard that ice cold water gives cramps and that sports drinks will make them crash. Is it a myth?
That's somewhat of a myth. Definitely cold water is better out there because not only are you actually hydrating yourself, but you're actually cooling your body, and it's going to help prevent the heat stroke effects. Room temperature water is definitely better than nothing. It's not, mm-hmm. not bad. It's just the cold water is definitely more refreshing. It'll actually
do you throw ice into the big coolers out at the high school?
Yes, we do.
Okay, mm-hmm. Well, if that's what you guys are doing, I'm sure that's the way to go. And then Drew Tomlinson asks, I'd like to know the best way to rehydrate. After lots of sweating, I get cramps, which I suspect is a bit of dehydration. So I drink tons of water, but it feels like it just goes through me. If my body really needs a liquid, why doesn't it hang on to it?
Well, water is definitely good, but you also want to add in some kind of electrolytes in there as well to help prevent the cramping and things of that nature. So drink performance drinks like Gatorade and there's a lot of other ones. Mm-hmm. Those are good in moderation. You don't want to be just drinking straight Gatorade. That's a lot of sugar. But adding in some things like that or taking salt tablets or things, yeah. Or even just not being too modest with the salt shaker, at the table.
Interesting. And you can always, water the Gatorade down a little bit, too.
Yeah.
Something that's a little bit more reasonable for your body.
A lot of people do that.
Some great tips for you. Isn't it nice that we don't have to worry about the heat today?
It is great out right now. I wish it was going to be like this all day.
Well, your kids are going to be okay for another couple of days. Matt, thanks for joining us.